Okay. Hiya, lovelies. Welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, my name is Amy and I am a cruelty-free makeup enthusiast. I am so excited for today's video because I have a super special guest with me.
Yay!
This is Lauren from Little Blushing Birdie. She is a very good friend of mine. We've been friends for a little under 6 years now, I want to say. And we just discovered about a year and a half ago that we both love makeup.
Don't know how it took us that long.
Don't know how it took us this long, no. But we are both very obsessed with products, and I'm just so happy to have her here on my channel because she is someone who I have admired for so long. She posts really great content. It's so aesthetically pleasing. So you're welcome. So I will make sure to link her channel, her Instagram, her blog all down below. So please be sure to check her out and to subscribe. So in today's video, we're drinking wine.
Yes.
Would you like some wine with us? Yeah, cheers. There you go. We're having some rosé.
We're going to need it for today's video because this whole video was a challenge.
This was a challenge and a half.
This required some work.
Yep.
Was not easy.
No. And I feel like so what we're doing, I should probably preface this before I begin, that we are actually doing the If I Could Only Keep 10 Palettes challenge. We decided to keep this strictly eyeshadow palettes because it was too hard to incorporate face palettes into this. But it's hard because I feel like my choices kind of change depending on my mood and the weather. So
Ophelia.
Yeah. So we have them. So should we just go not in any particular order? We'll just do keep doing one at a time with one another. So would you like to go first as the guest?
So I will say for any of you who decide to go and check out my channel, I actually filmed this exact same video in April of this year. So I did this once before. So I was kind of cheating because I already had like narrowed down my collection once before. However, I have changed some of my picks from last time because I've gotten some new palettes in my collection since then. So that definitely switched things up. So I will let you guys know which ones are the same that I would still keep from that last video and which ones I've replaced with something else. But it was still hard. I actually have 11 palettes in front of me, I'm realizing right now, because I didn't make up my mind. And I think on the spot, on the fly, we're gonna have to get rid of one of these.
Fair enough.
We'll figure it out as we go.
Totally so, fair.
All right, so let's see. Do we have any that are the same? I don't think that we
really
do.
Funny if we do.
I think ours are actually different, which
they
is...
are. Yeah.
I'm looking at your stack.
Yep.
I think that all of ours are different, they are which different. Is actually pretty impressive.
That is
goes to say
impressive.
How much makeup there is out there. That's actually
There's
really,
a lot.
Really good.
Yeah.
So I say, because I see that you have a Novla palette.
Yes.
Shall we start there? I will start with a Novla palette.
Cool.
So, the first palette, this was one of the ones that was in my original that I said I would keep last time, and I would still keep it because it is one of my absolute favorite palettes ever, ever, ever. Anyone who watches my videos knows I'm like kind of stupidly obsessed with Nabla. This is their Soul Blooming palette, which Amy, I know, just got.
I just got it. I'm so excited.
We placed an order together on Nabla's website for Black Friday and got a bunch of stuff. Mm-hmm. And I haven't seen Amy since then, so I just gave everything to her today.
Yeah.
So I'm excited for her to crack into this and try it out and see if she falls in love with it as much as I'm in love with it.
Because, I can't wait.
Okay, first of all, gorgeous color story.
Ah.
It's like everything flowery and pretty, which is 1,000% my aesthetic. The mattes in here are just so good. Nabla's matte formula, especially in this palette, is excellent. This blue shade, flowery, for a periwinkle blue, awesome. Like, so pigmented and so smooth, so easy to blend. It's one of my favorites.
Yeah.
So, this, 100%, if I had to get rid of everything else, like, I could not part with this.
Very good choice, and I cannot wait to play with it. So, my Nabla palette is the Secret palette. First of all, can we just appreciate the front of this, the artwork.
I love it so much.
It's just so cool. It's so unique. And it almost has like, what would you call this? Like a faux crocodile?
That's like a faux snake skin kind of thing. Yeah, it's got a really cool texture.
Yes, it's got a really cool texture. And this is just so beautiful. So I knew that when I saw the inside, I would fall equally as in love with it. So this to me is great because you can do so many things with this palette.
Yes.
Because there are the neutrals in here. you have like that neutral brown, you have a black, you have a lighter shade, but then you have pinks, reds, rosemary. This shade right here is just so unique. And this shade Addiction right here.
Gorgeous.
Gorgeous.
I love this palette too. Yeah. This I almost put in mine. I was like super close, but I actually ended up going with another Nabla palette instead of that one because as much as I love this palette to death, I realized that most, like, I probably could create similar looks with some of the other things that I picked. So if I was trying to think, you know, okay, if we're going with that, if I can only keep 10, I'm trying to think of the whole collection as a whole and not just on what I love. So this one didn't make the cut for me.
Yeah.
But it almost did.
Yeah.
It's a fantastic palette. Mine looks way more beat up and disgusting than yours.
Mine's a little bit newer. Yeah. Mine, I think I got this in the fall, sometime this fall. So I've only worn it several times. I did wear it on Thanksgiving. I wore it on Christmas as well. And it's just such like a lovely, lovely palette. And again, it's one of those things that, you have to look at your whole collection. It's not just your 10 favorites. It's like, what can I get from other ones that I can't get from other palettes? Yes. So, but this is just, the formula is just so good. Not enough love is given to Nabla.
100%.
And it deserves more love. The brand is awesome.
100%. So glad that they're at Ulta now, because now all of us in the US can actually like more easily get it without having to spend a ton of money on international shipping.
Yeah.
To that point though, it's really good to make friends with people that also are obsessed with makeup, because then you can go in on an order together and get free shipping.
Cheers to that.
Yes. So while we're on the topic of Nabla, the other palette that nudged out the secret one for me a little bit was this guy right here, which is the new Nabla 2 Dreamy palette. This is the Mystic palette. This is so beautiful. Honestly, I don't think the camera really does this justice.
It doesn't.
The way this looks in person is so sparkly and so beautiful. It's just unreal. And these shadows in here, they're not glitters. They're not a pressed glitter like the way the ColourPop ones are. They're not chunky. They're really, really fine, sparkly shadows. And they are just so like impactful and light reflective and beautiful. Like, I can't. I'm gonna swatch one. This one, Armor Cord.
Ooh,
oh my goodness.
Look at that.
Let us see.
Oh my goodness. Like, the pigmentation on that was just insane.
It's so shiny and so pretty, and just the like little micro fine shimmers in there just catch the light. Ugh, it's delicious. It's so, 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 so good. And these tones, they're just so rich and pretty. I just feel like this definitely kind of, I don't know, hits all the right notes for me. Like, as much as I love the Secret palette and I think the shades in there are gorgeous, I think the textures in this palette are really unique. So if I had to like only pick 10, I feel like I wanted to add a little more variety and not pick 30% Nabla. Like, I felt like that might be a little overkill, so I decided to try to be a little bit, you know, ruthless and keep it to 2. So this one, I feel like the textures are so special.
Yeah.
I had to go with that one.
Yeah, it's, now that I've seen it in person, it's unlike anything I've ever seen before. And I remember when I first saw it, I was like, oh, I don't need that. And I'm like, I'll probably buy it. Yep. But it's just, again, that one swipe that you did, it almost looks like it's wet, which is so unique.
It's just
beautiful.
And on camera, I feel like glitters never really pick up the same way they do in person. There's, for whatever reason, the lights and everything, it just can't capture the brilliance. So if you ever have the opportunity to like see this in person, I highly recommend just watching it, testing it out, because so pretty.
Yeah. All right. So for my next one, I actually have a grayscale palette. This is the Lime Crime Venus Immortalis palette.
Ooh.
So I was like, if I'm going to go cool toned and more grayscale, because I do love grays. I really do. First of all, again, with the packaging, I love the marbled Venus, the Botticelli Venus that's on it. And it's just... Ooh. Yeah.
That shade right there. Actually, both of the shimmers in there are my jam. Those are so pretty.
Echo and then Hail. And I'll show you. I'll swatch these because this is just like,
ooh. Oh, those would be so pretty all over the lid.
It is. It's so pretty over the lid. I don't know if you can see that, but they're just so beautiful, and I highly, highly recommend this palette if anyone wants more of like a gray scale or cool toned palette, and it really is, it just performs so well. So I can't say enough good things about it. I was so happy when someone came out with gray tones. I know ColourPop has their smoke show one now, but this came out a little bit before that, and I was really happy I picked it up because it's just so unique. Yeah. And it is the last of the Venus line that they're doing, which I'm kind of surprised about, but I've just had nothing but good luck with their shadow formula. They're very easy to work with, very easy to blend, so that's why I have this one in my list.
Sweet. Yeah, I've never tried a Lime Crime shadow before, but that definitely has me intrigued.
Absolutely.
While we're on the topic then, so I used to have my list from the last time I did this, I picked the Pixie Natural Reflections palette because that was a little bit more cool toned. Mm-hmm. It does have gorgeous shimmers in there, really, really beautiful, and I struggled with that one. I thought about keeping that one, but I ultimately decided to switch it out for this guy right here, mm-hmm. which is the Alter Ego Sahara palette. So this is a dupe for the Natasha Denona Biba palette.
Oh, is the Biba one the purpley one?
No, that's the Lila.
That's the Lila. Okay, so maybe that's the Biba one.
Yes,
yeah.
Because the Safari is the all matte one.
Right,
yes,
right.
So I think this is the Biba palette mm-hmm. dupe, which is kind of like a more neutral palette. Mm-hmm. But I figured at least one of the palettes that I kept should have a matte black
yes.
and some grays because nothing else that I kept does. I was like, all right, let's be a little bit practical. And this is a really nice, affordable palette, $16. And the shadows in here are actually really nice to work with. They are not like the best shadows I've ever used in my entire life, but I feel like this formula is really solid from Alter Ego. And this just for me was like a good filling in the gaps kind of palette, like from a practical standpoint. Mm-hmm. You know, I do have some colorful things in here. I wanted something that was a little neutral and anchoring. So mm-hmm. I thought this would be a good one.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, and I love the soft touch. It has like that soft touch packaging. It's very satisfying. I like that a lot.
Soft touch. All right, so let's see. I will go with, I had to have a pastel palette in here because I do really like pastels. So this is the Strobe Creepy Cute palette. This
That's a blast from the past, I feel like. Oh my god. I remember this from years ago.
Yes.
People being like really into that palette. I don't think I've ever actually seen it in person.
Oh, well, that's ready. So there it is.
Yes.
And it's just so unique. I actually have like 2 to 3 kind of more on like this kind of scale of pastels, but they're all different. Mm-hmm. And this one, the formula, Strobe has now rebranded as Shroud Cosmetics. So if you're ever looking for them, that's the one. We filmed mm-hmm. a video before and I couldn't think of the word Strobe Cosmetics. I had gotten their Divinity palette during Black Friday, which is their other one. But you could still buy these. They still say Strobe Cosmetics on them, but they are now Shroud Cosmetics. So, in here, I just love it because you have a very unique, this green right here is like nothing I've ever seen before. It's just this like really vibrant.
That's like a true lime green.
That's
right there.
A lime green right there. But then you also have, you know, the baby blue. Mm. And then you have this kind of lighter green here. You have the lavender, the pink, and the orange. This black, too, is probably one of the strongest matte blacks I think I have in my collection. The gray is also stunning. But let me just show you how this gray is super creamy, too. Ooh.
Oh, I can already see.
Yeah.
It goes off.
Do you see that? I know.
That black is.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Can never go wrong with a matte black shadow. Yeah. I feel like you don't need it for every look.
No.
But it is the best thing ever if you're wearing a gel liner or even liquid liner. I always like to set it.
Mm-hmm.
Helps keep things locked in even longer.
Absolutely. Yeah, so it's such a unique palette. I almost decluttered this because I have another pastel palette and I just thought, oh, I don't need too many, but I ended up taking it out of my declutter just because it is so special and unique. So I'm very happy that I have this in my collection. And also feel how heavy this is.
Ooh.
Right?
That's nice.
Yeah.
It's got a nice little heft to it.
Yeah.
Next on my list. Okay. So this is another one that was... This is a very loved palette of mine that anybody who watches my channel knows I'm obsessed with this. This was one of the ones I, you know, was in my top 10 last time. Huda Beauty.
Mm-hmm.
New Nude. This is like me in a palette, though. I love blush tones and purpley tones, and I love all the textures that are in here. So you have pressed glitters, you have these really, really cool, shimmery, very unique foiled shades. Like, I don't even know how to describe these. They're kind of unlike anything else. that I have in my, I know, oh, right?
Yes.
So they're very similar. Actually, those two are actually really similar in tone.
Yeah.
But this one's a little less glittery, a little more foiled, but just so nice. And
beautiful.
And the mattes in here I actually really like as well. I find them to be, they're a little dry to the touch, but the way they blend on the eyes is like really nice. Oh,
wow, look
like,
at that.
Right? Right?
Oh, God.
It's so good. Wow. I feel like this is something I always get a beautiful look out of. Like, anytime I reach for this, I know my makeup's going to look good. So it's like a good tried and true love of mine. So this is one I could, like, never part with.
Yeah.
I really like this. Not to mention the fact that it's stupid expensive.
Yes.
So, and I bought this full price. I very, very rarely do that. Mm-hmm. But I wanted this badly enough that I just forked over the money for it. And zero regrets. Because I've gotten a lot of use out of this.
That really is a beautiful palette. And I've seen Lauren use it so many times. And it really is you in a palette.
Yeah.
Can we talk about me in a palette right now?
Yes.
This is my all-time favorite palette. This is the ColourPop Good Sport palette. When I saw this, this came out last fall. And it's just, again, ready?
That is a gorgeous palette.
Yeah. It's probably, and again, it's just perfect. You don't need too many shades. Like, having this 12-pan palette, you get enough diversity in it to do whatever you want. You could go with the green looks. You can match the green and the purple, which complement each other so well. You can do a sunset eye right here with these purple and the yellow. And it has actually one of my favorite shadows of all time here, which is Rookie. This is a burnt orange with blue shimmer in it.
And that's stunning.
It is. You can't really pick it up on camera as well. But this in person is just so unique.
Oh, I like
and
that a lot.
And I like, if I could only pick one palette for the rest of time to have, it would be this one. If I were to create a palette, it would probably look something like this because these are all colors I really gravitate towards naturally. And it's just so good.
Yes.
It's so good.
I love ColourPop's 12-pan palettes.
Yes.
They're for the, like, not even just for the price. I mean, like, they're excellent regardless.
Yeah.
But then when you also consider how affordable they are, it's kind of like, it's kind of tough sometimes to justify even other palettes that cost three times as much because it's like, are they really that much better?
Yes. Yeah. It's so true. And it's, what's great about them too is they're so long wearing. Like, ColourPop, I just always feel like there's such a dependable formula that they have that I know that if I go into it, I'm going to get a good eye look and then I'm not going to struggle to apply it. So, great palette.
Actually, so to that point.
Yes.
I have one as well because, of course, I couldn't not. So, I picked the Sweet Talk palette, which this I did not have when I filmed this video in April because I don't think this had come out yet. Come out, I hadn't bought it yet. This one I definitely hemmed and hawed about for a while because I was like, I don't need it. I don't need another warm tone neutral palette, but eventually I caved and I'm so glad that I did because I absolutely love this palette and I've gotten a ton of use out of it. Like I've traveled with this because it's just one of those things where again, even though it's kind of monochromatic, like this is not the most diverse or interesting palette. Like you're going to primarily get peachy looks out of this. But every look you create is going to be beautiful and it's going to be easy and it's going to be fast. So this is something when like I just want a pretty straightforward look that's not overly complicated.
Yeah.
I can reach for this palette. The Super Shock that's in here side to side is so pretty. Ooh. Like if you just want a really ethereal look, you can just like put this all over the lid and just maybe throw a little bit of something into the crease and it just gives you that very wet, shimmery, fairy-like kind of look to your eyes. I'm all about soft, pretty looks. Of course, here I am. I was saying, I'm all about soft, pretty looks, wearing like the most intense blue smoky eye right now. We had some fun earlier today with the getting ready video that we filmed. It will be up on my channel.
Yep.
You guys can definitely check it out.
I'll link that down below too.
But this is a beautiful palette. I think this was the first palette that ColourPop launched that debuted their pressed glitters in one of their palettes, which I know are controversial. Not everyone likes them, but I'm kind of a glitter fiend, so I really like them. I walk on the wild side a little with the glitters. Like, literally nothing else in my life. I am, like, the most play it safe. But I will put glitter on my eyes. So there's my rebellious wildness for you right there.
You know, I remember when they were started doing that, I'm like, I don't know how I feel about it. I'm not too much of like a glitter person, but then I have, which palette do I have that has a bunch of the glitters in it? It's the Truly Madly Deeply, which again, if you like kind of mauvey pinky, purpley mm-hmm. tones, and it has three glitters in it, but all three glitters are stunning. So mm-hmm. all you just, even if you just do the tiniest bit, it just adds this extra mm-hmm. dimension to yes. your look. All right, so what should I go into? Should we do ABH next? Because I can
sure.
do ABH. So
yes.
I'll start off with my most used ABH palette. This is my Modern Renaissance, and yeah. Yeah,
she's hit pan. I've hit pan. That is a sign of true love.
It's a sign of true love, and I'm so close to hitting pan on some other shades, but again, there's just something about this palette. I know that this was like the first palette to really go there with the neutrals plus mm-hmm. the berry tones, but there's just this shade Love Letter, which is like a true berry color to mm-hmm. me, is just so beautiful. And I know that no matter what look I do with this, if I pick this up, I'm going to get a good look out of it. And mm-hmm. it's so dependable. And that's why, and I do love warm neutrals and berry tones. So naturally, I have to keep this. Mm-hmm. But you get that orange and that deep brown, which is very nice. Mm-hmm. And typical ABH formula, it's very easy to blend and work with. So that is why I had to choose this one.
You know, I have never owned that palette.
Really?
Really. I feel like, what the heck kind of beauty guru am I that I've never owned Modern Renaissance? But I think yeah. at the time that it came out, yeah. I like had a lot in my collection. And I was like, you know what? I just felt like it wasn't a smart purchase for me at the time. And then Soft Glam came out.
Yeah.
And so I ended up buying that, which Soft Glam was in my original mm-hmm. 10 palettes I would keep. Because mm-hmm. I do really love Soft Glam. But I replaced it this time around.
And I don't
around.
Blame her, because this is a good one.
Like, this is... Okay, so this is a... Well, actually, I think by the time this video goes up, my Best of Beauty for 2019 will have already gone up on my channel, so it won't be a spoiler. But mm-hmm. I haven't posted yet, so it feels like a spoiler now. So this was the palette I picked as my favorite of 2019. I love this palette so much. I know Jackie is a little bit of a controversial influencer. People have very strong feelings of love or hate towards her. I personally do enjoy her channel a lot. I think she's hilarious. But this palette, no matter what you think about her, is just so good. This is just like...
Yeah, it's beautiful.
It's a stunning palette. This, to me, is like one of the best color stories. This, to me, feels very much the way that Good Sport does for you. And there are actually some tonal overlap, actually, mm-hmm. between those two palettes. Because you have the mix of, like, the orangey colors,
yes.
the purples. You have a little bit of the green. I mean, Sponsored is a little mm-hmm. bit more of, like, a blue-brown green mm-hmm. than that being more of, like, an olivey lime.
Yeah, definitely.
But I feel like it's a similar kind of deal where... The possibilities are endless with this, where you could go more pink purple, you could go a little more neutral, yep. you could go more warm. Like, I feel so inspired every time I look at this palette, and I never get bored. Mm-hmm. It's one of the few things that, like, I reach for constantly, and every time I use it, I feel like my makeup comes out beautiful, and all the shades in here,
they're
like,
beautiful.
They perform so well. ABH can be, their eyeshadow formula can be inconsistent. Like, you have, you know, Modern Renaissance, they did great things with Soft Glam, I feel like, also great. I feel like the mattes in here are very similar to those two palettes.
Yes.
They're very similar. And the metallics in here are kind of the same deal, but, like, honestly...
Yeah. The duochromes in there, those two especially, are very unique. That's Dwalas, right?
Dwalas. Dwalas. It's just so... Yeah. And then, I think, Zam.
Yes.
I mean, oh my god.
Yeah.
Let me put it here.
Like... Oh, yeah. That's... Beautiful. I own this palette too, and I absolutely love it. I remember when they first released it and teased it, I thought that's the prettiest thing I think I've seen in such a long time. Mm. People said it was boring. It's not boring.
I know. I thought that a lot of people, when they, like, I remember when this got leaked. Like, it was leaked, and people were posting about it on Reddit before Jackie had announced it, and people were like, oh, that's such a boring palette. I mean, then again, people on Reddit are a little harsh, in my opinion. But regardless, I don't think this is boring at all.
No, it's so interesting. I think too, especially this shade Pinker right here, it's such a deep pink. Like, and the fact that it could show up on all different kinds of skin tones is what really makes it unique. But you can go really deep with this, which if you build it up, and I love that shade so much.
I feel like that's a really nice thing about the mattes in here. They're so flexible. They're so easy to manipulate. Like, I use ginger all the time, and it can be the most beautiful light wash of color, Or it can be, like, totally saturated and super pigmented. And I feel like a lot of the mattes are the same deal. They don't get patchy when you sheer them out.
Yep.
Which I feel like sometimes can happen with really pigmented shadows. Yes. Like, they'll stick.
Yes.
And they'll get really patchy if you're trying to sheer them out. Mm-hmm. So then you can only really use them fully opaque and, like, mm-hmm. packed on. And you don't always necessarily want that.
No. So sometimes you want something light.
Sometimes you want a blend. So I think this is just, for me,
yeah.
a no-brainer. Like, must keep.
Right. So to continue on the ABH train, I actually have the Soft Glam here. And this is much newer to my collection. I held off on buying this for so long. Lauren used it on our friend for her wedding. And I saw it and I went, oh. And I caved and I bought it after that. And because it's just such a wonderful neutral palette, that's why I have to have it in here. Because I do have a lot more colorful palettes mm-hmm. in the ones that I'm keeping. I feel like I need just those basic mm-hmm. neutrals. But it's not, it's basic, but it's not basic. Because these shimmers here, particularly sultry,
mm-hmm.
it's so this pretty. Bronze and then rose pink. And then the actual bronze. So yes. we have, let me just, why not? We're going to go there, so.
We're going to be covered in swatches.
Yeah, we're going to be covered in
swatches. It's a good problem to have.
Yeah, seriously. Just, they're just so beautiful.
Mm. I love that palette. Yeah. I do really love that palette. There yeah. was a reason why last time that was yeah. one of the 10 I would keep. Because it's, the formula again is mm-hmm. is so solid.
Yep. And two, this dusty rose shade just yep. appeals to me because it's that soft rosy
mm-hmm.
shade. And then the mulberry too is just something I like. It just mm-hmm. adds a little extra something than to just, they're not just brown tones, mm-hmm. which I really appreciate. And again, because this is a very similar formula to mm-hmm. Modern Renaissance, that's why I love it so much because they also pair very well together.
Yeah, totally. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that... I have definitely probably used that palette more than anything else on other people.
Yeah.
I'm not a professional makeup artist. I don't like do makeup as a profession, but
mm-hmm.
For friends and family because they know that I'm so obsessed with makeup. I've done makeup for friends' weddings several times and almost every single time I've used the Soft Glam, if not exclusively as like a supplement because there right. it's just so reliable, so dependable, and the shades in there really are very timeless.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. Perfect for wedding makeup or wedding guest makeup.
Yes.
So if you're like, I'm a wedding guest and I don't want to be too out there, but I want something really romantic, this is the palette to go for
yeah.
sure.
Yeah, a solid, like, I think of everything ABH has ever done, if you're like, which palette should I buy? I don't know. Like, this is the one I think that, like, anybody could use
yes.
for any occasion. Like, yep. if you don't want a lot of makeup, this is the one that you mm-hmm. could have and, like, it's going to be... kind of like a standby, never gets old, we'll always do you
right
kind of palette.
Mm-hmm. I'm just going to do cuts of us drinking.
Basically, yeah.
Yep. This is what we do when we hang out, too. We drink a lot of wine with one another.
Yes.
She brings that out in me. We have very similar personalities.
I bring it out in a lot of people, yeah. apparently. I don't know what that says about me. Lauren, she'll
yeah.
give you wine, you'll have good conversation, you'll hang yes. out, you'll probably leave with some makeup.
Yes, the makeup fairy.
Basically
for sure.
Mm-hmm. All right, what is my next choice? Okay, we're almost getting to the point where I'm gonna need to have to make a decision too.
Yes.
Because I'm okay. Mm-hmm. So this one was one that I think I had from my previous video as well that I also was still gonna keep because I do love this palette so much. First of all, A++ packaging.
Yes. Like, it's shiny.
It is so shiny. As a glitter lover, like, mm-hmm. this is just, I can just do this all day.
We're a bunch of magpies, too. It's, like, shiny, drawn to
yeah,
it.
Yeah, 100%. So, this is the Dose of Colors Friendcation palette that they did in collaboration with Desi and Katie. And this palette has been in my collection now for a while, and I absolutely love it. I have reached for this. I don't even know how many times for like special occasions when I'm going to events. When I went to Ipsy Live last year, this was the only palette that I brought with me for New Year's, for weddings, when I want to do something like really glitzy. This palette,
mm-hmm.
100% an easy go-to. So first of all, you have a bunch of really nice like neutral mattes that are just simple, can go with everything. You've got a nice variety of light and deep shades. All of these work really well on my skin tone. I know some people that are really fair said that they struggled a little bit with some of these because they were a little deep. They are very pigmented. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, these are...
Oh, wow, look at that.
So buttery, so smooth, like...
That's like the chocolate matte of my dreams.
Right?
Right there.
Like these are gorgeous shadows. I find the mattes to be very easy to work with, but it might also be because I'm not the fairest of the fair. Mm-hmm. So take that as you will. But really, this palette, it's all about the shiny shades that are in here. I mean, let's just have a moment for this blue. Like, can we?
Oh my goodness.
It's just so pretty. Falls over and dies.
Yes.
No. Yeah. These glittery shades in here are just like the prettiest thing. Like, look at that.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
For just like all over the lid. When you want that like wham bam dramatic, gorgeous, like makeup look, something that's super ultra glam. This is just it's so much fun. It's so pretty. I love the green shade in here too, Dirty Martini.
That green. I love the name of it. Oh,
Dirty Money.
Either way, Martini or Martini Money. I accept.
same difference. So yeah, this is one of those that just I time and time again reach for, never really get sick of.
Yeah.
So this one was like, I was torn. These last couple of palettes, I kind of felt like, oh, I don't know, because I have 11. I was trying to, you know, narrow it down to 10, but I don't think I could kick this one out.
It's very pretty. That's the first time I've ever seen it in person.
Really?
It's beautiful. Oh. Yeah. Again, it's like, there's so many palettes that I want, but I'm like, oh my gosh, you have so many.
Yeah.
You gotta put a stopper on the palette buying.
Yeah.
All right. So I think I have another Lime Crime palette, actually, surprisingly. This is the Venus XL. This is the red palette.
Oh.
Yeah, I love reds. I love red shadows. And so here you get a really nice balance of like burgundy, lighter reds. You have more of like a coral in here.
There's some beautiful colors.
Yeah, there's some really beautiful. There's definitely pinks. There's a magenta. And for anything like red toned, this is the one I go for. I've actually decluttered a lot of other red palettes because I like this one so much. You have Blank Canvas, which is the perfect just starter shade or to blend out any kind of rough edges. And it's just such a really beautiful palette. And none of them are too similar. And I've used this actually on my sister-in-law. She was in a wedding where they had kind of like a Merlot type bridesmaid dress. And so I did her makeup using this palette, and I thought it just came out so lovely. So they just have some really interesting shades. There's some more that are much more metallic, but then you have these ones that are more of like a matte but with shimmer in it. Like this kind of, I don't even know how to describe it. It's a dusty lavender with shimmer, and I don't even know if this is going to pick up on camera.
Yeah, it's sort of like, I feel like between a mauve and a taupe.
Yeah. It's very, very interesting. And so I really, really like this palette. So I always tell people, if you have the smaller Venus palettes, you don't need this one. But if you don't have any of them and you want like the red toned one, you could probably skip Venus 1 and Venus 3 and just get this one and you will be set. So love this. And again, the formula is just so easy to work with. It is a pricey palette. I want to say it's like in the $50 range, I want to say.
It's funny. I feel like that one reminds me of like what Huda is, but like on steroids. Yes. Like this, this is not like, just feel like they're, this is like the toned down cousin, sister in this one. Like they both have that similar kind of purpley pink. This is just way more, way more neutral.
Absolutely. Much more toned down. But they're less make saturated. Very good companion palettes, I think.
They could totally hang out and be friends.
Yeah. And you do get, they did throw in this kind of like brownish, like this lighter toned brown that you could put in your crease because everyone always wants that. So it's just such an interesting palette. And again, I love the Botticelli on it. A little art history there for anyone who's into that sort of thing.
Totally. All right. So let's see. All right. The next one I know I'm definitely going to keep before I start getting myself into difficult territory is this guy right here. This is a newer palette to my collection. And I actually surprised myself with my choice to keep this, but I ultimately did it because of the color story that's in here. And I really wanted to have a couple of these shades. So this is the Folklore Cosmetics Paris palette. So Folklore is a newer-ish brand. They had sent me a bunch of stuff earlier this year that I tested out on camera and I actually had a lot of fun in that video. A lot of stuff was surprisingly a lot better than I thought it was going to be. So this is what the inside looks like.
So pretty.
It's super pretty. This again kind of reminds me a little bit of Good Sport in that you have a very similar kind of green shade in here. I honestly kept this for the green and the yellow that's in here because I love these shades so much. And there are a few really cool, like, duochrome-y sparkly shades, like this one, Tuileries, and Croissant. Mm. Like, they have some really cool, multi-dimensional, colorful sparkles to them that's super unique. I've been very impressed by this palette. The mattes in here feel like butter. They're super, super soft. The pigmentation on them is actually pretty nice. Like, it's very
good yellow.
Yeah, it's not like, you know, the most insane thing, but it builds on itself well, and it blends out really nicely. Let me swatch one of these shimmery shades so you can see, because this...
Oh, look at that.
Isn't that pretty?
That almost reminds me of a caramel apple.
Right?
Is that a weird thing to say? Because there's kind of like these caramelly, but there's like these green tones in there too.
Yes, yes. So the shimmers are like a lime green, but it's like in this caramelly gold base. Super, super pretty. So this is one that I actually have found to be a like surprise favorite. Mm-hmm. Like, was not expected, but I just have really enjoyed this. I think you get some really cool, unique tones in here. So I think this is something that I would... enjoy keeping in my collection. Oh, I want to swatch one more. This La Vie en Rose, or V en Rose one. Again, kind of similar deal where... Oh, maybe that one's not swatching is good. Hold, please.
Hold, please. Gotta fix the swatch.
Gotta fix the swatch. I'm like, my fingers are so stained.
Oh, yeah, mine too.
Swatching so many things.
But oh, yeah, that's really pretty.
I, you know what I think, too? These also apply better over a tacky base. So, like, if I go in my NYX glitter primer and then layer the metallics in here on top, yeah. Super, super beautiful. This one is supposed to be like a dupe for the Huda.
Oh, yeah.
The Huda type shades.
Those are so unique, though, that texture there. Oh, yeah, look at that.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Really, really pretty. I need to wipe some of this off because I'm running out of room.
I know we're running out of room.
I also am living dangerously right now.
You are.
A white sweater in a swatch video.
Yeah. Oh, man. All right.
So what's your next palette,
Amy? My next one from Menagerie Cosmetics is the Feral palette. And it was a struggle to choose one of them because I also have the Killer Purr, which is much more neutral. But first of all, again, the artwork. So again, green is my favorite color, so you'll notice that there are a lot of greens that I'm keeping, but I feel like every single one of the greens that I have is different. So but they have this purple is probably one of the strongest vegan formula purples I think I've ever tried. I just want you, I do want you to just dip your finger and feel how smooth.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh.
I know. Ooh, look at that. Do you see that? Do you see that? That is exactly the reaction I was hoping for.
Like, I think you just had a moment.
Yeah, I know. And the shimmers, too, are just stunning.
Wow, that's really nice.
Yeah.
Dang.
It's such a strong palette. It originally...
And for a purple?
Yeah, and for purple. Which is incredibly hard to formulate.
Yes.
Purples
are
very hard. And that is probably one of the strongest purples that I have in my collection. And every time people are like, I really want a purple, this palette is it. You get, you have the pinks, you have some neutrals here, you have the bright yellow, the orange, of course, this like teal shade here in the corner. And it is just a beautiful, beautiful palette. I would say that Menagerie is probably one of like my top five eyeshadow formulas. Again, indie brand. I just love supporting them. And they used to be called Makeup Monsters back in the day. And then they rebranded as well. This happens a lot with any indie brands. So you might hear me saying that over and over again. That's kind of a trend with them as they kind of like find their niche in the market. So, but it's just so beautiful. And that purple is just worth it.
Gorgeous.
Worth everything. Yep.
Gorgeous. All right. This is the moment of truth time. And really, it's like these three palettes are the ones that like I struggle the most with to try to like narrow it down. I think I know what I'm gonna kick out, so I'm gonna just kind of give this an honorable mention. I love this eyeshadow formula so much, and I kept this was in my original 10 palettes I would keep video in April, because I kind of like the idea of having a smaller palette, and this is probably one of my most used palettes like on the daily ever. But I think if I was gonna have to only keep 10 now, I might switch it up a bit just to have a little more color variety on hand. The Persona Copper Color Theory Kit.
Ooh. So,
this is, like, it is honestly just, like, one of the best eyeshadow formulas. Like, it's so good. The copper shade in here.
Oh.
Right?
Oh.
It's like one swipe swatch, just yeah, boom. Boom. And like the mattes are just, they're also really nice. They're very, very easy to work with in that they're pigmented, but they're not so pigmented that they're difficult to buff out, to blend, to work with, which is generally my preference. Mm-hmm. So this is just like, I do genuinely reach for this all the time. I think if I ever have a shot of hitting pan in an eyeshadow, it's going to be this light brown shade right yeah. here. Like, I'm going to call that now because I use it all the time. But
super pretty.
But we're it's not making the cut, which is like saying something because yeah. it's a really good palette. The thing that I kicked it out for, I changed my mind.
Ooh, Juvia's.
Is yeah. the Magic Palette
yeah.
by Juvia's Place. Really just because so much of what else I kept is not super colorful, and this is by far my most colorful palette. Mm-hmm. When I did this video last time, I kept the Carity Mattes palette, which is a very, very colorful all matte palette, and I actually decluttered that one because I really did. Wasn't using it. Mm-hmm. It's a great palette. I just don't wear a ton of super colorful looks all the time. Again, says the girl wearing a blue smokey eye. I like playing with color, but I feel like more often than not, I'm generally wearing more soft looks, pinks, purples, neutrals. So I just don't feel justified in keeping a ton of really colorful palettes. But when I feel like playing, I feel like this has so many fun options. Like this green, every time I swatch this palette,
oh my God, look at that.
I go into this green.
That is an emerald green. Look at that. If I've seen one.
Look at that green. It's just unreal. That's Christmas right there.
That is Christmas.
I missed the boat on that one. But there are some other really, really gorgeous shades in this palette. I also love this purple duochrome. Like, this is super fun. Like, look at how pretty that is.
That's beautiful.
Oh, I hope you guys can see this on camera. I cannot see. I'm so blind without my glasses on.
Oh,
and I'm just a blur looking at the viewfinder right now, but it's all right. So, yes, Magic Palette by GRWM is a totally excellent, excellent palette. Their formula is great. I think most people that watch beauty videos here know GRWM's Place has got great eyeshadows that are very affordable.
Yeah.
I do not use this enough.
Yeah.
2020. Resolution. Use the Magic Palette by GRWM's Place, Lauren.
Yeah. That's the thing. It's the GRWM's Place palettes that I own do not get enough love. It's just, but the pigmentation is just out of this world. Because again, they keep women of color in mind too, which mm-hmm. I think is so smart. And I just love that it will show up on any kind of skin tone. So, mm-hmm. yeah.
You know what I think it is with GRWM's Place is their eyeshadows are excellent, but the color stories of a lot of their palettes are not the easiest to use, like, by themselves. Mm-hmm. So a lot of times I feel like the reason I don't reach for them is that most of the time I'm getting ready in the morning, I'm just grabbing one palette that I know, like, boom, I can create a look just with that. With GRWM's Place, like this palette especially, I probably am not going to create a ton of looks just with this.
You need other palettes.
I'm probably
going to
be, yes. So I think I just need to make a conscious effort to, like, look at this and be like, what is a shade I want to use? Mm-hmm. And then find something else to complement it and then create a look, because if I don't do that, I don't think to use it as much, which is why it's just not getting as much love as it deserves.
That's kind of how I feel about my Deuce palette that I have
yes,
from them.
It's
beautiful. Like, the colors together are beautiful, but I feel like most of the time I need to pull from other palettes to make a cohesive look.
Yeah.
So speaking of most colorful palettes in our collections, I do have my most colorful palette in my collection. This is the Nomad Antilles palette. Mm. Nomad, again, top five favorite eyeshadow formulas. These shadows are like butter. And I love Nomad because they're inspired by all different locations. So they take colors that are found in said locations. So I have the Marrakesh palette and also the Tokyo palette. And they're just so vibrant and rich of color. And they all have a story about where the colors come from and where they're inspired. And that just extra detail, that going the extra mile, makes me so interested in the brand. And again, super, I mean, we're talking about buttery formula, like the blues in here and the yellow. And let me just grab, I'll grab this El Florida too, because this is a beautiful, like, coral shimmer.
Oh, those look,
I don't know if you can
super
see
nice
that. Yeah, so if you just go bloop bloop bloop.
Oh, and those are really nice.
Yeah, and they're just so pretty.
Super pretty.
And it's again just very unique to my collection. I don't have anything else like this. And
I'm having serious FOMO right now.
Yeah.
Not gonna lie, you know why?
Mm-hmm.
Went to Ipsy Live this year. They totally had a booth. Did I
Did
stop
they?
At it?
No.
And I could have got, like, I know on, like, the Creator Day night, like, I'm pretty sure they were giving away, like, full-size palettes to people that stop by.
Oh.
Dummy, I am.
Yeah.
Dummy, I am.
No, it's, yeah, it's hard. It just, it's so cool. And then they have, like, a Berlin one, and they've recently come out with two Italian ones. There's one, they're miniature ones. One's based from Tuscany, and then the other one is, like, Cuomo. And just, again, just the color stories are so unique to the locations that they're based on. So, highly recommend these palettes.
Maybe it wasn't Nomad Cosmetics. It might have been IBY Beauty.
Oh.
But I know that they've had Nomad in subscription boxes before. And I know, I definitely am going to keep an eye out now.
Yes.
Now if I see something, I'm going to be like, okay.
Yeah.
Getting on that.
Yeah. If you can get it, like, especially, they do have sales every now and then. Mm-hmm. Highly recommend. I love the flamingos on this.
It's so cute.
It's so cute. I remember when this first was released, I'm like, oh, the flamingos.
Adorable.
Because I just, I'm a sucker for animals, you know? That's that's my gig, you know? Yes.
I see your last palette.
Yep.
And I'm super excited to see that in person because I've not yet seen it in person.
You'll get to see it.
Very exciting. Yeah. Okay, so my last palette, my 10th palette, this was another one that I had previously chosen that I am keeping in the rotation because it's such a good palette. Such a good palette. This I got in a BoxyCharm, and I'm so glad that I did. This is the LMR Cosmetics Reina del Caribe Volume 1 palette. Have you ever seen this before?
I've never seen it. It's beautiful.
Okay. The mattes in here are really good. Like, they're a little dry, but they're very pigmented.
Oh, they are pigmented.
They're very smooth, very easy to blend. They're a really nice matte formula. There's only 4 mattes in here, and they're pretty saturated shades. Mm. So again, this is a palette that, like, you can use all by itself for sure to create looks, but it does help sometimes to use other things with this, depending on what kind of looks you want to create, just to kind of, like, get a little more variety. This palette is, for me, all about the metallics, because they are just, like, unreal. I can't. Ooh. I love them so much. They're just...
Oh my gosh, look at that.
The blue...
Oh my gosh.
It's just so pretty. And they're so dimensional and just shiny and...
Oh yeah, that's beautiful. I love that shade right there.
El Malecón is like, it's so unique. It's like this grainy gold antique kind of color. Mm-hmm. And that was like, I was stressing between this and the Persona because I knew I was like, I should keep the Magic palette. I got rid of the Carity one. So like, I want something colorful. And you know, I do have other metallic blues and other warm tone neutrals in other palettes that I picked. But this formula is just like, it's so good. So even though I love the Copper Color Theory palette, I think it's really great. I couldn't like pick that one over this because it's just,
those metallics are special. And that's the first time I've seen it in person. Like, I've heard so many good things about this brand and it's so pretty.
Yes. The LMR Cosmetics is Latina founded, female founded. The girl who started the company, Gabby, used to work for BoxyCharm then started her own business. Mm-hmm. And everything they've launched so far has been really nice. They have a face palette that they also did sample in BoxyCharm, which is awesome. That's so pretty.
Yeah.
Their Colorecte Blush Trio, gorgeous. Like, I would 100% love to try more from them. I know they did launch another eyeshadow palette, and I don't have it, but they look like really great companion palettes. Like, together, I think you could create some really beautiful looks. So that's definitely on my to-buy-someday list.
Yes. And we all have those to-buy lists because we would have just way too much if we bought everything.
Right. For serious.
For sure. All right. It's
last
time.
But not least. Oh, I feel like... You saved a good one. You saved a good one for last.
Yeah. Guys, this... I'm not a big, like, a big palette person. So, as you can see, like, the largest palette that I have other than this is, you know, the Venus XL. So, I normally don't have these bigger 30 shade kind of palettes. It's not as big as it actually you would think it looks like. It's, you know, it's not as big. So, it's not like a Morphe palette.
Yeah. Like, the Morphe Jaclyn Hill palette is substantially larger than that.
And I just have to... First of all, Kathleen Lights, thank you. Thank you for creating this. Everything you tend to do is just so well thought out.
Yes.
And I love when she works with ColourPop. This is all gemstone inspired, which is very on trend right now. Mm-hmm. And it just, there it is.
It's so pretty.
What I love so much about this is that I'm so inspired by it because I see quads when I look at this. These shades go together, these shades. I mean, of course you can go across the board and use all of them, but I just see colors that it's so well thought out in the placement of where the shades are. And if the shades are just, I mean, you could do this turquoise and this purple, and then you have more reds, and then you have this citrine, and oh my god, this period shade, like for green lovers.
That's beautiful.
I know. It just, yeah. Beautiful. And I think, you know, they have two glitters in here that are both, you have like a warmer toned one, a cooler toned one. I love the balance. I love this, like just this little area right here. Is beautiful. Also, this diamond one, I think this one is a
looks like a Super Shock.
It's a Super Shock shade. So let me just, yeah, because it's super.
I remember her talking about that particular shade and that formula, like just being so, like just like a, like almost like a topper of
it. It is
shimmery, really pretty. Mm-hmm. Just adds that little extra ethereal something.
Yes, it's like the effervescent fairy, you know. Just
the,
yes.
Topaz shade right there is giving me so much life. Yes, so that's like a glitter. Ugh.
Topaz is a glitter shade.
Like, yeah. That would be just so pretty. Oh man,
it's beautiful.
Beautiful.
Stunning. So you know how you were saying how Jackie Ina is your favorite palette, which is, it's a phenomenal palette. I have that one too, but this one is, and out of all the ColourPop palettes too, like if you're only gonna get one ColourPop palette that was released this year, for me it would be this palette because it's so diverse and versatile, and it's got the gemstone, the gem inspiration, and I love it, and I don't think I would ever get rid of this thing.
See, I love Kathleen. Mm-hmm. I watch her channel religiously. Mm-hmm. I think she's adorable. She, like you, is an Aquarius.
Yes.
And I have a soft spot in my heart for Aquariuses because I think they're truly fun and just good people. And I saw that and was like, oh my god, I want it so bad. But I have so many eyeshadow palettes that I like didn't let myself buy it. But man, it's, and I think it came to Ulta.
Yes.
I don't know if it's still there or not. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you can still get it there, but I don't know, man. I feel like this is like the Jaclyn Hill palette from Morphe, but like the newer, better version.
Yes.
Like, I still have that palette and I've been thinking about decluttering it. Mm-hmm. And part of me feels like this should replace it because it's just superior in every way.
Yeah. And I just love that no shade is too close to one another.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
They're all a little different. They're different. So, whereas I mean, because I've only seen the Jaclyn Hill palette, like in stores. I don't own that palette, but, and I do love that, but I'm just like, oh, some of them are kind of like on the same.
Warm tone neutrals, there are a lot of shades in there that are similar. Whereas that feels to me like a rainbow palette that's not a rainbow palette.
Yes. Exactly. It's like, if you don't want a rainbow palette, if you want colors, that's what, again, that I love so much about this, that if you want to play with color, but you're maybe too afraid of colors, this is also a great option for you.
Yeah.
Because it is, it's like safe, but there's still like a lot of depth to it.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Beautiful. All right. Well, we did it.
We did it.
We did it. We have our wine.
We do.
You know, again,
cheers
to us for getting through this thing.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
All right, guys.
And here's to never actually needing to declutter our collections down to only 10 palettes.
Yes. Here's
because
to not having to do that.
That would be a tragedy.
I'd probably cry.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd probably cry.
We'd have to like pool our resources and share makeup.
We would. I mean, that wouldn't be a bad, like, we'd probably have a lot of fun. We'd probably hit pan a lot faster.
Also true.
So, you know, the struggle is real.
Yes.
But anyway, guys, thank you so much for hanging out with us today. If you made this through the whole video, again, thank you so much for watching. Hello to all my new subscribers out there. I've seen a recent influx with you guys. Thank you so much for, you know, taking your time and spending your time with us today. Please remember to check out Lauren's channel. She is so talented and I absolutely love her content. I'll link all her information below, and I'll also have the link to the video that we did together, which is the Get Ready With Us. And so that is our top, 10 palettes to pick from if we could only choose 10 to keep. Please let us know in the comments down below what palettes you would keep if you could only keep 10. So that is it from us today. We're going to sign off and probably drink some more wine. And until next time, remember to stay compassionate and chic. Bye, guys.
Bye.